Don't you just hate school firewalls? I know I do. But did you know that with a little bit of knowledge, they're actually pretty easy to get around? Stick around and within 3 minutes, you'll know all you need to know how to unblock websites at school. Before I show you how to work the magic, don't forget to like and subscribe for more tips, tricks, cybersecurity bits, and some juicy privacy control tool discounts. Okay, so standard practice in most schools across the world is to simply block access to any websites the school administrators don't think of as educational or anything that might distract you from learning. A lot of these firewalls simply stop you accessing websites that actually help you with your work anyway. So if you don't know how to unblock sites at school, you can say goodbye to all of your external essay sources. Plus, those downtime apps like Instagram, Snapchat, Messenger, YouTube, and of course, anything gaming related. Most admins are like, students don't know how to unblock websites at school. They're dumb, but in reality, it's pretty simple. There are three methods you can use for getting around these firewalls. First, the simplest and easiest is to use a VPN. Now, having a VPN simply means that you know how to unblock websites at school. You're the go-to website unblocker. Anyone needs to access a website? You got them covered. The best VPNs have everything you need to get around blocks. Most importantly, accessing everything through a remote server. For example, if you try to access steampower.com on the computer in your library via a VPN, the computer won't know this is what you're doing. It will seem like you're just connecting to a VPN server. We recommend NordVPN, Surfshark, and ExpressVPN as good places to start. We've already made videos on these and you can check them out right here. If you're not sure about VPNs and if you're new to the whole VPN thing, I totally get that. Try a couple out for free first. Check out ProtonVPN and AtlasVPN. While they're free, they're not exactly premium. In other words, they're not the best of the best. Still, they're worth checking out if you're learning the ropes, especially if you're learning how to unblock websites at school. The second method I'm going to talk about is proxies. Proxies are features of some VPNs, but there are loads of free websites that do the same thing for our intents and purposes. A couple issues with proxies though is that many schools have already blocked a good few of them. Don't worry though, there are thousands of web proxies that can't block them all. The other thing is some proxies are quite shady, so make sure to protect yourself before using one. And finally, the third way, and this is a fun way to unblock websites at school, but it won't always work and it's not good for all situations. Over at archive.org, you'll find the Wayback Machine. Just type in the website and it'll take you to a recent version of it. Pretty fun, but not so useful if you need to log in, for example, as it just stores a snapshot of the website. Okay, so at the end of the day, from these three methods, VPNs, in my opinion, are probably the best way to unblock websites at school. And on that note, remember to subscribe to the channel for more how-tos, VPN news, and ballin' shoes. Alright, well, maybe not the last one. Check out our description below for some cheeky discounts on some of the best VPNs out there, and until next time, go unblock some websites, you crazy kids.